Hey folks, Sirdar here with a new episode of Dev with Sirdar, and in this episode, I'm going to look at some of the most notable fonts for coding as of 2023. Now, you might not be in the habit of thinking about what fonts you have set up in your editor. Editors typically come with some default font that you get accustomed to, whether or not it really suits your needs. So in this video, I'm going to give a quick tour of some of the popular fonts right now for code editors, and also for general use, and show you how they stack up against each other. And if you're already a font maven, stick around. You might see something new. So let's start with one of the most common fonts, especially if you're on Microsoft Windows, and that's Microsoft's Consolus. And this font comes bundled with Windows as a more readable and upscale replacement for the old Courier font. And because it's so common, it's hard to go wrong with it. And it's got good support for all of the stuff that a programmer needs, like symbols and diacriticals and non-Western characters. But it's a proprietary offering. It's a Microsoft thing. And for some folks, that's a sticking point. Another thing Consolus doesn't do is it doesn't support ligatures. This is the ability to do things like render certain character clusters as if they were a single character for the sake of aesthetics. I will say right now, I am not a fan of ligatures, but I know some people really like them, so many of the fonts that I will be talking about here do support them as an option. Now, if you don't like Consolus because it's proprietary, you could consider Cascadia Code. It's an open source font created by Microsoft for their also open source Windows Terminal project. So it receives updates a little bit more aggressively than Consolus itself, which is generally bundled with the OS. It's a little wider and bolder than Consolus, and it has more distinction between easily confused characters like the number 1 and the lowercase l. I also like the dotted 0 as opposed to the slashed 0. And also, unlike Consolus, it has support for common ligatures. But if you don't want that, there's a ligature-free version called Cascadia Mono. So it has an easy substitute for Consolus that works very nicely, and you have both options to choose from. Next up is a font called Fira Code. It's got about the same font weight as Consolus, so it's a fair substitute, but it is wider by default. It's more spacious, and it comes with ligature support right out of the box. And one consequence of it being more spacious is that things like parentheses or braces are much more spatially distinct. And you can also choose variants of the font that use either a dotted or a slashed zero, or that vary the height and placement of the descenders, like the G or the Y. And you can build those variants custom from source if you want to tweak the font's behavior manually. But the out-of-the-box version works beautifully. Now, speaking of hackable fonts, this seems like a good place to segue into the discussion of the appropriately named hack font. It has the same basic weight and width as Fira Code, and it also has comfortable spacing for braces and other programming punctuation. And the designers of the font also provide tooling for making it easy to customize the font. For instance, by swapping the dotted zero with the slashed zero, or by changing default line spacing. So if you are super finicky about font presentation, and you like the hack look, and you like the idea of experimenting with changing your fonts manually, this is a good place to start. Now, if you like the idea of hacking your fonts, but you don't want to mess with the command line or a tool set to do it, there are a couple of options. One of them is a font called Monoid. This, by the way, is a very strikingly narrow and thin font. It has a very light default weight. It's capable of packing a lot of code into a single line. It gives you plenty of spacing for programmer symbols, and it has good distinctions between similar-looking characters. But the best bit is if you want to play with its options, there are variant versions of it available for easy download from its homepage. You can choose the variations you want, you can edit the default line height, you can change the tracking, you can toggle ligatures, which are on by default, and then download a customized version right then and there. Now, I personally find Monoid way too skinny and ephemeral looking for my taste, but that may be because I've settled on a smaller font size by default, so Monoid tends to sort of vanish for me. Now, in the same vein, as far as customizations go, and with even more options available, here's a font called Input Mono. And of the other fonts here, Input Mono feels closest to Fira Code in terms of its look and feel, but it also has a wide range of easy customizations for things like letter forms and line heights and so on. So if you're bewildered about what all these options amount to, one of the beautiful things about Input Mono is that you can test out an interactive demo in a web browser. You can see what the customizations look like and then download the customized version for your own use. Now, word of warning, Input Mono does have a licensing agreement, which makes it free for personal use, so it's okay to use on your own machine. But if you want to use it for publishing, such as using it on a website or in printed matter, you must purchase a license. So if until now you've just settled for the default font offered by your editor, or you're intimidated by the sheer range of options out there, I recommend taking some time and experimenting with a few of these choices, see what you like. Because odds are, if a font strikes you as being a good or bad fit out of the box, it probably is. And that means it'll be a good base for further tweaking, if you choose to tweak. So that's it for now. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.